Hello and welcome to Food News Today. Now, here's a quick tip to jumpstart the new year and a new you. If you want to boost your metabolism and improve your heart health, why not try to add spices to your meal? Researchers at Penn State University gave two groups of volunteers two identical high-fat meals. They then added a mix of spices, including rosemary, oregano, and cinnamon, to just one of the meals. And guess what? Those who ate the spicy meal saw a lower increase in their triglycerides and their insulin level than those who ate the bland meal. So I guess now there's no excuse for bland food. The National Restaurant Association has just released its restaurant industry forecast for 2013. And you might be surprised to find that some of your favorites are, well, just not so hot anymore. Sliders, bacon-flavored chocolate, out! According to the survey of some 1,800 chefs across the nation, that is. So, what's in? Well, a dietary focus and health concern issue. Smaller portions, vegetarian appetizers, whole grain options for kids, and wheat-free pastas. Going local is also predicted as a hot trend, such as locally grown organic produce and vegetables from restaurant gardens. And let's not exclude house-cured meats, artisanal cheeses, and gourmet lemonade. And technology is predicted to make a bigger impact on the restaurant world this year, with the new trend being in-house iPad menus. These menus will show customers high-res photos and detailed descriptions of all the dishes. And finally, if you want some international flavor, Peruvian food is predicted to be the hottest fad in ethnic cuisine this year. And international-inspired items such as chorizo scrambled eggs and coconut milk pancakes are also predicted to heavily influence these menus. You may have heard by now that the FDA is expected to approve genetically modified salmon. Now, the company responsible for creating this is Aqua Bounty, and their salmon would be the first laboratory-created animal approved as food here in America. Until now, all FDA-approved foods have been plants. The FDA recently signed off on the environmental safety of genetically engineered salmon, which means that these fish are getting even closer to being released in a grocery store near you. Do you agree with the FDA that this will not have an impact on the environment? And what do you think of genetically engineered fish anyway? And last up, someone else who's been looking ahead at trends for this year is marketing and communications brand JWT Intelligence. They recently released their things to watch, and number 21 on their list is dads in the aisle. Like yours truly, they predict marketers will start zeroing in on dads, not just moms. With women just as busy in the workforce as men, they and I both agree that we'll start seeing men taking a bigger role in the kitchen and in the supermarket aisles. Another item on their list is faux meat. With consumers cutting down on meat consumption due to their budgets, environment, or health concerns, faux meats are getting tastier and more convincing. They also predict menu-free dining will become popular. While some restaurants try to accommodate the fussiest of eaters, well, JWT predicts that more restaurants will adopt the opposite end of the spectrum and provide customers with a limited pre-fee menu. The concept is big in Europe and has recently been making waves in New York and in Chicago. I guess we'll all just have to wait and see if any of these trends, theirs and ours, come true. That's all for this week's edition of Food News Today. Don't forget to check out supermarketguru.com and send us a message on Facebook or Twitter. I'd love to hear from you. Food News Today is sponsored by ConAgra Foods, who shares with me the desire to provide the most current, interesting, and unbiased food news. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.